One of the things we have to understand, especially those of us, the scientists, is that you cannot carry out conservation without the community. If the community is not in support and if you don't get them involved, then you would have a very big problem.
Good morning, sir.
Morning, how are you?
Fine.
Almost everyone you find here, they are members of this community. So from the field assistants, from those involved in the Smithsonian project, the Smithsonian team, they're all members of the community. And I think this is a wonderful thing because it makes them part of what we're doing.
Ngel Nyaki is wonderful to our community. The project employed the people from Yelwa community only.
We all know about the ecosystem services that forest provides and vegetation provides. We have serious challenges with deforestation. We have serious challenges with even places that are meant to be reserves being degraded, and no one is saying anything.
My goal in terms of conservation initially was to restore the forest. The Smithsonian has welcomed us into their family. They have allowed, in a sense, Ngel Nyaki to become part of this global network of forest plots.
It is also the only Afro-Montane research plot. So I think there's a lot to be learnt from this plot. And the whole network, the CTFS Forest Geo Network, is so that we can share data, we can compare data, and also with the recent interest in climate change, I'm sure that the plot is going to make significant contributions into understanding global climate change.
We know how the forest is in 2015. We will resurvey this plot every 5 years, and we will see how things have changed. Because having such detailed information means that we can follow ecological change through time.
I think that this place is hold for us, and especially for the communities around, so much benefit. And so I think that it's very important that this forest is maintained. The only way to do that is for us to have more research being done in areas that are still more novel in Nigeria, and then also to have the government interested in what we're doing.
I hope if you are here today, in 10 years coming, you will miss some places because they will become forests. This was a grazing area before that they were not free, but we have planted a lot. If you look at where our fence is, our forest is coming back. In 10 years coming, I think it will grow more than that.